Hello guys, I am Tejaswini Ramani Yadav, Assistant Professor at HM College Karad. Today we are dealing with types of variables which are present in a Java language. In earlier video we have seen that what is a variable. So variable is nothing but a short piece of memory where we can store program data or class data. So in the language directly dealing with the data is not recommended. So programmers have to make use of variable concept. So one variable can store only one data, and if we want to store multiple data in one variable, then we have to make use of array concept or pointer concept. But pointer concept is not supported by Java, so we have to make use of array only. So now in today's video we are going to see what are the types of variables. So first one is a local variable. So the variable which is declared inside block body or inside method body, it is treated to be as local variable. And it is also called as a temporary variable. And if we use local variables, then there is a no concept of default value. Means if we declare integer a and then we want to access the value of that a, then we do not get the value of a. The program will be compiled but not executed, because integer value, default value for integer is 0, and if we do not assign any value to a, it will give us a result that means error, program is not executed, it is compiled but not executed. And local variables are going to store inside stack, which is present inside JVM. JVM is stands for Java Virtual Machine. So next is global variable. Global variable means the variable which is declared outside the class body or method body. It is treated to be as global variable. So global variable, it is also referred to as permanent variable, because global variables are going to store inside, if it is a static variable, it is going to store inside heap area and static pool area, and if it is non-static variables, it is going to store inside heap area. So we can access global variables by using class name, by using object creation, and we can access local variables by using object creation. Means static variables are, we can access static variables by using class name, and we can access non-static variables by using object creation. We can we have only one copy of static variable, because static variable is accessed by using class name, and here we have only one class of same name. So we have only one copy of static variable, and we can create object of by creating object of class, we can access non-static variables. So we can create multiple objects of any class. So we have multiple copies of non-static variable. Next is main method. So main method is very important point in a Java language or in a class, because our program executes from main method, and main method it is also called as entry point, because execution starts from main method. The syntax of main method is public static void main string array arguments, then open curly braces and close curly braces, and inside that executable statements are allowed, and it is called as a main method body. Next is scanner class, and here main method is public, because public is an access specifier, and by using public access specifier specifier, we can access main method throughout the our package. Means anywhere we can access the main method. That's why it is a public. Then static. So why we declared main method as a static? Because if we want to access any of the method, then they have to create object, and then we can access by using that object reference variable. We can access that method. But here, if we use static here, then we don't have to create object of that class, and by we can access main method directly. So we can use the main method as a static. And next one is a void, which is data type. Data type. Why it is void? Because if we want to give the any data type to a method, then suppose here is the integer or float or double, anything other than void, then we have to return statement, which is at the last statement, and which is mandatory statement. Then if we use here void, then we don't have to return any kind of a statement. So void does not return anything. So we can make use of a void at the main method. Main it is a we can say it is a word defined by the programmer to identify the main method. So here we can use main. And string array arguments, it is a argument given to the main method. Next is a scanner class. So a scanner class is used because if you want to give the or take the input from a keyboard, then we have to make use of a scanner class. So if you want to use scanner class, there are we have to follow some steps. So first step is we have to import scanner class where it is a present. So scanner class is present inside java.util.scanner library. So first step, we have to first declare or create import. We have to import actually. We have to write this statement at the first, means we have to import java.util.scanner library. The next step is we have to create object of scanner class, because if we want to access that, we have to create object. So if we want to access, we have to create object. So next step is object creation. So we can actually scanner is a class. So scanner SC is class name, and object reference variable, which is SC, is equal to new scanner. The syntax of, if you want to create object of class, the syntax is class name object reference variable is equal to new and class name. So by using that syntax, we can write the object of scanner class as scanner, which is class name. SC is, it is a we can say object reference variable is equal to new, it is a keyword, and the scanner, which is class name, and we have to pass argument as system.in. System.in means we have to take inputs from keyword. So system.in represents we have to take input from keywords keyboard. So next step is storing, or to store values entered by user, we use certain methods. Means if you want to access the inputs which is entered by the user, so we have some certain methods, or for storing we have some methods. Next, if we have used integer value, or end user entered or given input as a integer value, then we have to take use of next int function. If suppose we are taking the input as integer age, so it is an integer, or while accessing it, we have to make use of int LTH is equal to SC dot next int function. So like this, for double we have to make use of SC dot next double. For float we have to make use of SC dot next float. And likewise for boolean we have to make use of SC dot next boolean. And by making use of string, we have to use only SC dot next function. Next.